You know, I'm not gonna lie, it feels like it's been forever since I've done an album review, and it's only been 2 weeks. Why has 2019 been off to such a slow start? Come on, people, speed it up. Anyway, Ariana Grande, new album, Thank You Next. This album has been much talked about, much Bollywood, much discussed. Ariana Grande is someone I don't need to introduce, one, because she is a pop superstar that everyone knows about, and two, because on my blog, I reviewed all four of her previous studio albums. Yours Truly, My Everything, Dangerous Woman, and last year's Sweetener, all of which I loved, and I'll have those reviews linked down in the description if you want to go check out my thoughts on them. This is her fifth studio album, and it's the follow-up to, like I said, last year's album Sweetener, which I really loved. It was a much different direction for Ariana, but I thought it was great, and it had some of her best singles to date, like No Tears Left to Cry, which might even be her best song to date. I know that's really tough to say. It might be a crazy opinion, but I really think it might be her best song. And in terms of the numbers, Ariana had a massive 2018. Obviously, the album came out to great reviews and much success. No Tears Left to Cry peaked at number 3 on Billboard. God is a Woman got to the top 10. Breathin' finished just below the top 10. But Ariana admitted that 2018 was not only the best year of her career, but unfortunately the worst year of her life. Which I can understand, because, not to get into my own personal anecdotes, but 2018 was also the worst year of my life. And because she went through way more than she probably needed to in 2018. She dropped an amazing album that got huge sales and did so well, and then had to deal with the loss of Mac Miller, her ex, and the turmoil from her relationship and breakup with her ex-fiance Pete Davidson. And it was even to the point where I think she tweeted something along the lines of, I wish I could have a good day, I feel like I haven't had a good day. Again, I related that quite a bit in 2018. 2018 was tough for me. But that's really, really sad. She comes out with such a great album, she seems like she's on top of the world in terms of her music. But again, it shows, fame isn't always the answer when you're not feeling great. But she ended 2018 off with a banger with the title track from this album, Thank You Next, which got to number 1 on the Billboard Hot 100, her first number 1 hit, and she basically said that it was going to lead into a new album, which kind of had me a little skeptical, because even though I've loved her albums previously, I did kind of wonder, is it too soon for another one? Granted, I did like Thank You Next, the single, and the follow-up track, Imagine. I thought that they were both very nice, but I was starting to fear a little bit because of Seven Rings. Even though that got to number 1, I can't lie, I haven't really dug the song all that much. I wasn't sure what to think about it at first, but repeat listens have made it grow away from me. And then she had to get Barbecue Girl tattooed onto her hand. Ari, I love you, but honey. Either way though, you know, she's dropped these singles and hyped up this album, and now it's finally here, and I'm reviewing it at 1:50 in the morning, but who the fuck cares? It's 12 songs and 41 minutes, so it's not too long. What I want to say is most surprising to me is that there's no features on this thing. Not that that doesn't make sense. I mean, of course, this is apparently a much more personal album for her, so I can imagine it being just her. But her previous albums all had features to them. Her first album had, of course, the late Mac Miller, her ex Big Sean. My Everything had my boy, The Weeknd, Childish Gambino, ASAP Ferg. Dangerous Woman had Nicki Minaj, Future, Lil Wayne. But then Sweetener had Pharrell, Missy Elliott, Nicki Minaj. This is the first album Ariana has put out that doesn't have any features on it. Again, tells me it is going to be a bit more personal, so that's interesting to me. Anyway, like I said, 12 songs, let's get into it. Track number 1 is Imagine, and given that it was already released, some of you guys probably heard it already. But for those that didn't, I'll play it in this video, so let's go. No makeup, you in the bathtub, bubbles and bubbly. Kiss me and take the feels the lows. Imagine a world like that. Love on my face fits a gold in your neck. Why can't you? After the first kiss, took a deep breath like ooh. Click, 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 and post. Chip, 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 and go. Can you imagine? Can you imagine? You guys could probably tell just by how I was dancing along, but I really love that track. Obviously, this album is Ariana again trying to do something a little more trap-esque, but it's still very soothing and relaxing. Obviously, she sounds amazing on it, and I kind of like that she's just talking about imagining like a really perfect world. It's sweet, it's nice, and I think that I liked the song when I first heard it, but listening to it again for this review just made it better for me. I think it was definitely a great song to start the album off on. Track number two is called Needy. If it takes too long to hit me back, I can't promise you how I react, but all I can say is at least I'll wait for you. I can be needy, so hard to please me. I know it feels so good to be needy. Sorry if I'm up and down. Oh, that chorus was great. Oh yeah, I like that. It kind of feels a little bit raw. It's interesting because Ariana is very open about her flaws on this track and how she is a needy person. And she sounds amazing on the song. Her vocals are great, of course. We all know that Ariana is a great singer, but she sounds great on it. The chorus is great, as I mentioned earlier in the video. It's very low key for her standards. And I feel like outside of the songs that have obviously topped the charts, I have a good feeling the rest of this album isn't going to be as poppy or as immediate or as radio friendly as some of her other stuff. But if the music's good, then the music's good, and I really like that song. Track number three, NASA. I just want to say with that song, Ariana made a better trap banger than Seven Rings. Honestly, I think that that song was better for me than something like Seven Rings because, first of all, I think it's interesting that she mentioned needing space in a relationship by literally mentioning space and NASA. I think that song plays better to me than Seven Rings because it plays better to her vocal talents. Vocally, she sounds way better on that than she does on Seven Rings, and I think it's super smooth, super nice. I love the trap drums on that song. Her vocals are great, the chorus is fun, even the N-A-S-A. I like that too. So far, really liking this album. It's still early, but I think it's good so far. Track number four, Bloodline. Ooh. I was wrong, this does have some pop appeal to it. I think it's single worthy, honestly. It's got single potential. I said it earlier, I think that actually has some single potential. Obviously, it's got kind of a poppy, upbeat feel to it, but I think I really like it because it's a nice mix of Ariana's old and new sound, in that it's got the kind of poppy edge that I feel like I could recognize on one of her older records. Like, I could see this being on, like, maybe Dangerous Woman. But beyond the fact that it sounds like one of her older tracks, I think it also sounds like it has some new school edge to it to keep it fresh. I don't know why, I feel like I could see this being on something like Dangerous Woman, but at the same time, it sounds to me like something that could also be on Sweetener, and I think that's what I kind of like about it, that it mixes some of what we used to hear from Ari with some of what we hear now. And again, her vocals are great, the production is very catchy and fun, and I think that her vocals, of course, are fantastic, and she just sounds amazing. I feel like I'm not being super detailed, and I'm sorry about that, but one, it's 2 a.m, I got to recording this late, and I'm just kind of enjoying the album, so I guess I don't have much to say. Sometimes I guess not having a lot to say can be good because at least you're liking the album, and sometimes an album just needs that unexplainable something to be enjoyable, and I guess so far this has it. Track number five, Fake Smile. I love that. Oh, that was so fun. I just want to say the confidence on that bridge and just the charisma, I love that. I also love the song because I really kind of feel for the subject matter of it. She's kind of talking about how she doesn't want to fake a smile. If she's not feeling good, she's just going to say it and be honest about that. And as someone that battles with anxiety, I tend to be very open with people when I am not feeling good. I don't like to hide my anxiety behind a smile. I'm very open with people when I'm not feeling my best. And I think that's why I can really relate to something like that. And I think that the instrumentals are lovely and kind of downbeat, which fits with the subject matter. I feel like something more upbeat and vibrant may not fit with a song like this. So it sounds great, and obviously her vocals are amazing. I gushed about that bridge already, but the rest of the song, she sounds amazing as well. So far, so great for this album. I was a little skeptical, like I said, but you know, I think that she's handling this move into trap instrumentals fine, so far at least. Track number 6 is Bad Idea. Ooh. Oh, I thought that would be a beat switch. I kind of heard that and kind of thought of it as being a little bit like God is a Woman without, obviously, the female empowerment to it. That one was fine. Again, I like some of the trap instrumentals on it. I think that Ariana handles them nicely, and I also think she sounds great on it. I feel like the only things that are keeping it from being one of the more memorable tracks for me are that I'm not really all that crazy about the hook on this one. It's just not really the most compelling one that I've heard from her. And I do think the song goes on just a little bit long. Not a bad track. It's definitely pretty decent, just not one of my favorites. Track number 7, Makeup. I like to fuck with you, just to make up with you. Cause the way you be screaming my name made me wanna make love to you. Love it when we make I hear that instrumental, and for some reason I kind of thought of like a Pokemon game. I thought of that as being like Pokemon Red or Blue instrumentals or something like that, but it was good. I like those instrumentals, and I love Ariana's vocals. Some of her flows as she raps are actually really good, and I like the chorus. I like the play on words with makeup, and I like the sweet and lovely vibe of it. It's sweet. It's a nice track, and luckily at 2 minutes and 21 seconds, it doesn't overstay its welcome, and at the same time, it doesn't feel like it's missing something. It just feels like a good track. It feels structured nicely. Ironic, by the way, that it's sandwiched in between the two longest songs in the album, but nevertheless, track number 8, Ghostin. Well, you're sleeping next to me, but it's your arms that I need this time. This time. I like these filters on her vocals. You've been so understanding, you've been so good, and I'm putting you through more than one ever should. Got some violins on this one. Hmm. like that one too. Again, kind of like earlier on the song Needy, it's a song where Ariana's kind of embracing her flaws, talking about how she has baggage, but how her and this other person are gonna get through it. I like that. It's sweet, it's lovely, kind of hazy sounding, a little more minimal in terms of the instrumentals, but it's great for it. Obviously, she sounds amazing on it. I think that's just a really pleasing song. It's one of those songs that's pleasing on the ears, but also pleasing in terms of its lyrical content, so definitely dig that a lot. Track number 9, In My Head. We got a skirt on there. How about that? Trap drums are going hard here. Hazy trap banger, I really like that. Apparently that song is about imagining someone that's perfect and like them not turning out how you imagine them. And she sounds great. I think the hook was amazing there. Definitely one of the more catchy hooks on the album. And again, I think that Ariana sounds great over the trap drums. I like how hard they go towards the end too. I kind of worried that, you know, her moving towards trap would just be like, what the hell is this? Like really gross. But for the most part, it's been pretty good throughout this album. And that was definitely a standout for me. I really like that track. Okay, the next two songs are songs that you guys are familiar with, but I'm gonna play them anyway, even though you've probably heard them a bunch of times already. Track number 10 is Seven Rings, and I've already talked about how I don't really care for the song. I'll play it again because why the hell not? It is the number one song in the country at this point, so let's just play it one more time just to have it out of the way. I like this intro though. I like this part though, honestly. That's kind of it. See, I kind of thought that I'd like the song a little better in the context of the album just because, oh, it's Ariana jumping on trap. If I hear it with the rest of the album, maybe it'll fit better. But I think the thing that I don't like about it is that it feels so out of place. Like, it's a weird flex song for the sake of a flex song. It's like everyone says weird flex, but okay. Like, I feel like I hear that when I'm hearing this song. Like, you're embracing your flaws throughout this album, which is great, and you're being very open with us, but then suddenly we just get a flex song for the sake of a flex song. It's really weird. Obviously, there's the whole controversy about who she copied and how she copied and blah, 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 and Soulja Boy's pretty boy swag and all that jazz. I think my other problem is that this one doesn't really play to her vocal talents as well because, you know, there is that cool, like, doot, 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 like, that she's doing, but otherwise, the chorus is just, I want it, I got it, I want it, I got it. And it's just kind of boring. And it's really out of place with the rest of the album. I don't know. Not for me, at least. Track number 11 is the title track, Thank You, Next. And unless you've been living under a rock for the past month or so, you've heard this song. But for the sake of it being the title song, I will play it again. Thought I'd end up with Sean, but it wasn't a match. Wrote some songs about Ricky. Now I listen and laugh. Even almost got married. And for Pete, I'm so thankful. Wish I could say thank you to Malcolm, 'cause he was an angel. One told me R.I.P. Mac. I I'm so glad I haven't tired of that song yet. It's still super catchy. Obviously, she sounds great on it. And I kind of talked about this on my every top 10 Billboard song video, so I'm not going to go too deep into it. But I like how it's a mature breakup song. A lot of times when you think of a breakup song, you think of it being bitterness and pettiness and sadness. But I like how it's very mature, very sweet song from her. And again, it's super catchy. She sounds beautiful on it, and I can kind of see why it had the success that it did. I also want to say, I wish I can relate to that line about I'm so fucking grateful for my ex, but I've never dated, so I don't really have an ex to be thankful for. I guess I could still enjoy the song. Track number 12, the closing track. Break up with your girlfriend, I'm bored. I stand by it. That is one of the greatest song title names I have heard in my life. I only hope that the song is as good as the title. Just break up with your girlfriend. She's bored. That's so fucking funny. Funny thing is, actually, it's really catchy. That's so good. It gets better every time. Alright, I'm so glad I ended up enjoying that track, because that name just makes me laugh so hard. Break up with your girlfriend, I'm bored. I think I also heard that this is the next single that she's releasing. I can't wait to see what the internet does with this track. I feel like it's gonna be something crazy. But it's catchy. It's fun. I like the trap instrumentals on this one. And the hook is oddly catchy. As weird as it's gonna be hearing people just go, break up with your girlfriend, yeah, yeah, cause I'm bored. It's fun. It's really goofy. I think it's really weird. I think that if I was in a relationship and someone told me, break up with your girlfriend, I'm bored, I would feel a little creeped out. But I can't deny that the song is fun. If a song is fun, if I have fun with a song, I'm gonna end up going back to it. So this is one I think I'm gonna go back to. If for nothing else, just because it's a goofy concept. But it sounds great too. Overall, I really enjoy this album. And I shouldn't be surprised because of the fact that I am an Ariana Grande fan, but I think I'm surprised just because this is her second album in 6 months, and I kind of expected that so much exposure to her, or so much exposure to this music, would just kind of be like, ugh. Kind of like how some people don't really like Drake nowadays because of the fact that he releases an album every year, so it feels like you can't get away from him. I was worried it would be like that with Ariana, but I'm glad we got another album from her. Not because Sweetener was bad, because Sweetener was amazing. It was on my best of list last year, but this album is a worthy follow-up. Is it better? I mean, I can't really say yes, because in a way, I think it does have one of Ariana's worst singles yet in Seven Rings, but even with that track not being so great, I don't think it really brings down the project as a whole, because there's so many tracks that I do enjoy. Admittedly, I was skeptical about Ariana jumping on the trap train, but outside of Seven Rings, which is just a weird out-of-place flex song, I think that the trap instrumentals are used very tastefully here. She still sounds great vocally throughout this thing, and even if it's not a raw album, I don't think it really needs to be. It just needs to be a good album. It just needed to be fun and enjoyable, and, you know, even with all the talk about Thank You Next being all about her relationships, even if there are some references that I may have missed, I don't even think it really needed to be an album all about those relationships. Maybe she just had some creative juices left after Sweetener, or her experiences throughout 2018 made her want to do more music, and that's why she did it. So respect to her in that case, and respect to her for making the album good. Shout out to Ariana for putting out two albums in 6 months that I ended up loving. There's always a chance you could just love one and then not like the other, but I think both of them are great. Is this my favorite album from her? No. I think some of her albums are so great that it's gonna be hard for this to top them. But again, it didn't have to. I think with Ariana, I just wanted it to be a good, fun, enjoyable album. And I think it reached that very nicely. Favorite tracks on this thing? Imagine, Needy, NASA, Bloodline, Fake Smile, Makeup, Ghostin, In My Head, Thank You Next, and Break Up With Your Girlfriend, I'm Bored. I'm never gonna get used to saying that name. My least favorite track, again, would be Seven Rings easily. The only other track that was in between those was Bad Idea, which was fine. Not terrible, not great, it was fine. So overall, I think I can safely give Ariana Grande's Thank You Next an excellent. And I don't know who's gonna agree or disagree. Some people might just think the album is not great. Some people are probably tired of Thank You Next and are gonna be tired of Seven Rings, but I love this. Ariana, she did a great job with this album. I'm very impressed that she put out two albums in 6 months that were both great, and in my book, she's 5 for 5. As of right now, in terms of my reviews, no artist that I've reviewed has put out 5 projects, and all of them have gotten excellent, but Ariana's the first. So, congratulations to Ariana. She's put out 5 albums, and I loved each and every one of them. Not an easy thing to do, just because it's hard to put out 5 excellent albums, but lo and behold, thank you. Next, now, you could take your time on the 6th album. You've given us enough music to last for a good amount of time now. Take your time, enjoy your success, and hopefully 2019 will be a better year for you than 2018 was, because you deserve it. But that's just my opinion on the album. What did you guys think? Did you love the album? Did you not like the album? Was there something in it that I was missing? Or what did you think of it? You can leave your thoughts in the comments. Let's keep it civil. Let's make this fun. If you like the video, hit the thumbs up button and subscribe. You know, do all that stuff every YouTuber asks you to do that I won't beg you to do, because that's not really my modus operandi around here. If you want to, great. If you don't, I understand. Either way, thanks for watching this review of Ariana Grande's Thank You Next. I don't know when my next review will be. Hopefully soon. This year's been off to a slow start, but hopefully more people will put out projects soon. So stay tuned for my reviews of them. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you guys later. Peace.